Good morning, my dear fifth graders. I am here to congratulate each one of you on completing your journey in the primary years program. You are now the PYP graduates. You will be moving on to the middle school. It's exciting to move to another building, to move to another curriculum, and I'm sure each one of you is looking forward to it. And also you have some thoughts in your mind, as in, you know, how is it going to be similar? How is it going to be different? How will you manage? So for that, we have for you each of your teachers during the course of this presentation who will speak with you. They will tell you about the subjects that you're going to have. They're going to tell you about what they expect from you and what you will expect from those subjects. Now, if I were to tell you some of the similarities of moving from the PYP into the middle school. Well, one of them is you're still Candorians. You're going to still be in the same campus. And what is going to be different? What is going to be different is that you are going to be moving from one class to another for your subjects. Yes, you're going to have subjects, and you're not going to have a unit of inquiry that you had in the PYP. You will have subjects like integrated science, which is going to be chemistry, physics, biology together. You will have history, you will have math, you will have English and ICT and all these subjects. You will also have books for these subjects, which is something you did not have in the PYP. You will get lockers. The lockers are going to be given to you so that you can keep your extra books in that, extra notebooks in that, and only take the books home that you want to revise or you want to do your homework for. And that brings me to a point that you will also have homework, again something that you did not have so much of in the PYP, but you will have it in the middle school. The other big difference that you must get prepared for is that you're going to have exams, you're going to have tests. And there'll be small tests, they're not going to be very large ones to begin with, but it's something that you will have to get used to. At the end of grade 6, you will have an exam. But your teachers are going to make sure they support you, they prepare you, and it's going to be a beautiful, beautiful transition from the being primary school students to being middle school students. One of the other things that I've always said is that from being the senior most class of the primary school, you're going to be the junior most class of the middle school. So you're going to be taken care of, your teachers are going to guide you, and usually in a month or two, all children get so beautifully used to this new system that they start enjoying it. Well, you'll enjoy it from day one, but you will get used to your tests, you'll get used to your books, used to your teachers and your the systems of the middle school in a month's time. In case after this presentation also you have some burning questions that you definitely need answered, that cannot wait for August when you're going to join us, then you can write to your middle school coordinator, who is Ms. Deepthi Singh, and her email ID is deepthi.s@candorschool.com. So you can write to her and she will revert to you. I would like to wish you all the best for the summer vacations. Enjoy yourself, keep yourself safe, and I'm sure after such a long break of being physically in school, you will be looking forward to coming to school just as we are eagerly waiting for you all to come to school. Best wishes, best of luck, and lots of love.
Hi everyone. At Candor, we make sure that you will have a smooth transition from PYP to middle school. So the language skills that you attained in PYP are further enhanced in middle school. We emphasize on different styles of writing by including the various components of English literature. This will greatly help you to analyze short stories, plays and poems, and this helps in an easy transition from middle school to IGCSE. English in middle school is inquiry based, and the concepts are taught also through interesting and fun ways like debates, presentations based on research, linking to real life situations, etc. For example, the Amazon bushfire was used as a research based project to teach you all factual writing. We ensure we help you all to unleash your creative side by including limericks and haiku writing, etc. We also put a lot of emphasis on enhancing your oral skills. So we have JAM, which is just a minute, and you will speak impromptu on a chosen topic, which helps to drop your guard and overcome stage fear. And these, along with a lot of vocabulary exercises, are done after almost all the chapters. All of this makes English learning exciting, creative, and a lot of fun.
Hi everyone, I hope you're doing well during this time of confinement. My name is Vibha and I teach French at Kando International School. Today I will be telling you why studying an international language, particularly French, is very essential for middle and high school students. Like the popular quote in English, language is a roadmap of a culture. Learning a foreign language opens up various aspects to the learner. Additionally, knowing a foreign language is so essential during this time of globalization. At that, did you know that French, the only other language like English, is spoken across all the five continents? Therefore, learning French language takes the learners across various societies to experience and to explore various cultures. So, let me take you through what's in store for Kando International School students who take up French in MSP. First of all, we have some awesome CAS projects, like for example, the previous term, my Spanish language collaborator and I teamed up for a friendly match between a French team and a Spanish team. Additionally, you have other projects like you can be a news reporter to talk about what happened in Kando when you're doing your past tense. Things like poster making or even coming up with questionnaire in Google form and analyzing these answers in French language are also integral part of each theme. And on regular basis, we have various role plays related to each theme that are enacted out by students themselves at classroom level. So let me give you a little insight as to how it goes about. So our pedagogy starts with authentic documents, which include texts and audiovisual clips and also some audio clips. So what we as facilitators do is we exploit these authentic sources in terms of vocabulary, in terms of grammar, and in terms of civilization and culture, in order to help the student grasp all of these aspects and to be finally able to express in terms of either text or in terms of various other expressions. So you may ask me, isn't French a very difficult language to learn? I would like to answer by saying absolutely no. Quite contrary to popular belief, French language is quite easy to grasp, and yes, it requires certain precision to gain mastery over certain structures. But having said that, knowing French language makes possible a great deal of subtleties. Also, it does not take long to reach a level of French where you would be able to communicate. French language also has a particular appeal among students because of its soft, melodious, and a foreign aspect in it. Finally, the one important reason why you should study French is because knowing French language makes it possible for a student to learn various other European languages, including Spanish, Italian, and Portuguese. To conclude, I would like to say one thing. Choose French.
Namaste, my name is Vandana Dwivedi and I teach Hindi for grade 6 and 7. Most students coming from grade 5 to grade 6 already know me, as I also teach in PYP. My teaching methodology remains the same. We would be doing similar activities as done in PYP. But at grade 6 level, a basic knowledge of Hindi language is expected, like reading fluency and commonly used vocabulary. The focus would be more on comprehension and writing skills. You will be exploring language through various themes, and you will pursue various kinds of writing like story, paragraph, essay, letter writing, or poetry. In middle school, we have three kinds of assessments like formative, summative, and term end exams. During the assessment, you will have to complete the assignment in the given time. And this is where your reading fluency matters a lot. So I would request you all to read lots of books in Hindi during the holidays. There are plenty of books available online which should help you. I look forward to interact with you all.
Hello, welcome to the middle school program of Candor International School. In the language department here, we have two Spanish teachers. I am Reshma Ravikant and I teach the subject along with Ms. Cristina Delgado. In the middle school, we start with the absolute basics in grade 6. That would be right from your ABCDs and 0, 1, 2, 3 onwards. The course would primarily focus on two categories, comprehension and production. This is further split into four skills, namely reading and listening comprehension, along with written and spoken production. Now, you will be introduced to much more than just the language, to be honest. Beyond language structure, grammar, vocabulary, and context, you will also get to familiarize yourselves with the culture of the Hispanic world. Hispanic countries include Spain and other Spanish-speaking countries from Central and South America. Mind you, Brazil is not a part of it because their official language is Portuguese. The course outlines in general topics such as how to introduce oneself, greetings, exchanging pleasantries, salutations, description of people, whether of ourselves or our family members or someone that we know about, talking about our likes, dislikes, hobbies, recognizing colors, being able to recall the days of the week, months of the year, the varied seasons, climate, so on and so forth. Vocabulary lessons will focus on the themes of what we see in a classroom, the subjects we study at a school, for example. Then there is shopping, transport, travel, etc. The culture thread, it specifically touches upon people, for example, celebrities of the Hispanic world. You have places, sports, music, food habits, and festivals as well. Now, I hope all of this gives you an idea as to what to expect in the upcoming year. If you follow the guidelines and instructions given to optimize your learning and focus well throughout the course, then there is much to be explored in the field of Spanish studies. Ms. Cristina and I, we look forward to welcoming you into this brilliant, multi-hued, multifaceted world. And be safe. We hope to see you very soon. Ciao.
Welcome to 6th grade. 5th grade understanding will be used to build your concepts in 6th grade. I am your maths teacher, Ms. Ashna. I will help you to build deeper learning. We will cover similar topics but in much more details. In 6th grade, you will learn some of the topics which are numbers, geometry, shape and space, algebra, statistics and probability, etc. Learning will be fun because here we will do application-based question of the maths concepts. You will be able to analyze and apply the concepts in real-life situation. I expect you to be regular in class and submit work on time. Math is easy to conquer if you practice a lot. So, I would recommend you all to utilize your summer break to brush up 5th grade concepts. I will make sure that learning 6th grade will make a fun experience. I look forward to having you all in the class. Stay safe, stay home, and take care.
Hi everyone, I will be talking about how science is taught in middle school. As you all are aware that science mainly has three subjects, which is physics, chemistry and biology. In grade 6, we do not really separate all these different subjects and we treat it as general science or integrated science. But as you move on to grade 7 and 8, each of these subjects would be treated as a different subject. Coming to the textbooks and workbooks that we have, so once you get your books, you will notice that there are a lot of books for science. So you would have three textbooks, three workbooks, plus three notebooks. Why we have three textbooks? Because each subject has its own textbook. And all these books, six books that you have, you will be using it over 3 years. So until grade 8, you will be using the same textbook and workbook. So don't be too overwhelmed seeing the number of books. The transition would be really easy, and the teachers would guide you at every step about what is expected. Coming to the activities we do in class, so we have a lot of activities along with the content that we do, and it's some of them are research based. So we do a lot of research work, and then you would be expected to present them either by using a PPT or a poster. We also do many hands-on activities. So some hands-on activities you would do it in the lab. The others would be given as home activities, so that the learning continues at home also, and you would be asked to bring the results to the lab and share it with the rest of the class. We also have certain experimental demonstrations because not all experiments are child-friendly. So those experiments will be demonstrated so that you can see what exactly happens. And a lot of focus is given on how to improve your scientific skills. You would be learning the names of different apparatus, different instruments, how to use them, what is it used for. So that will really help in building your scientific skills. And we also have a lot of poster presentations that we do on various concepts. Other than the activities that we do in lab as well as in class, we also have a lot of events. I'm sure you would have come visited all our stalls during the National Science Day exhibition. So in grade 6, you will be an integral part of hosting the National Science Day exhibition. Other than that, the overall experience is going to be fun. There's going to be a lot of activities, a lot of learning, and we also focus on doing things way beyond the content and what is there in the textbook. So we hope you enjoy learning with us and explore all these different possibilities and have a great time in middle school. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Ms. Priyadarshini and I teach social studies in middle school. Social studies comprises of history, geography and civics. Through this subject, we explored the past and the present, the world around us and the role of government and civil societies. The subject enables students to get better at research skills and communication skills, both written and verbal. They engage in various activities that try to solve real-world problems, and that enhances the collaborative spirits among the students. They also get better at self-management skills. We draw our curriculum from IB and IGCSE so that our students can cope well in the higher grades. Thank you.
Hi everyone. Hope you are all doing good. Welcome to MSP. Middle school's ICT curriculum is designed keeping in mind the grade 10 IGCSE curriculum. So it's more like a top-down design. In PYP, you would have learned different types of application software, mostly practical oriented. But in middle school, you will be learning practical as well as theory. You will learn different types of designing software, creating simple apps, animation software, and programming languages. Students, be organized, be considerate, and respectful. Kindly ensure you meet all your deadlines so that you will not lag behind. School days are the golden days of your life. Enjoy it. See you soon. Bye.
Hi everyone, I am Satish, the robotic facilitator. In grade 5, we are focused on Lego education. Lego improves creativity and promotes refined motor skills. Children practice dexterity as they connect Lego pieces of different size and shape. This requires different amount of pressure to assemble and becomes a wonderful exercise for a little finger, which supports children in being able to control the pressure while writing. In grade 6, we will focus on the STEM education. STEM stands for Science, Technology, Engineering and Mathematics. STEM projects often focus on solving problems and can be based on real-world applications. I expect students to enjoy this learning process and active participants in STEM activities. Thank you. Stay home, stay safe.
Hello grade 5 students, I hope you are all doing well during this pandemic period. My name is Sudhanshu Dharkabe and I will be your dance facilitator for the upcoming year in middle school 6th grade. So this video is to brief you about what you are going to expect next year. So dance standalone has its own elements and components that we have to learn, which will help us understand dance itself better. Each and every form of dance has its own elements and components, so we're going to learn about that as well. In 5th grade, you have learned the main dance forms like hip-hop, western, contemporary, freestyle. This year, we're going to focus on specialized dance forms, like say under hip-hop, we have urban hip-hop, we have lyrical hip-hop, we have commercial hip-hop. Under contemporary, we have lyrical contemporary, we have modern contemporary, we have classic contemporary. So we're going to get into specializations. And we are going to focus on music, as to how to listen to music, because there is a lot of difference between a lead instrument and a bass instrument. So I'm going to teach you how to differentiate between the instruments, because this is going to help you to, you know, create your own movements listening to the beats, the instruments and the lyrics, how we are going to merge all of this and form our own choreography. We are even going to learn something called abstract choreography, which will help us create our own movements. As you all know, when you come to middle school, you will have a lot of opportunities for inter-school fest, where the rules and regulations are such as you have to do the dance on spot. So this technique, the abstract and the segregational method of listening to the song will help you to, you know, understand and grasp the movement fast on spot. So these are some of the things that you will be expecting next year. There are many more things, like we are going to create themes, and we are going to add in a little bit of drama for expressions as well. And there are many more such things that you're going to expect next year. I'm eager and I'm waiting for you guys. I hope we will, you know, create a lot of new pieces, a lot of new choreographies, and we're going to present it in our school and outside as well. Just stay safe, guys. Stay at home and stay healthy. I shall see you next year. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Hi, everyone. My name is Indrani, and I teach drama in the middle school at Candor. And I'm here to talk about drama as a subject in the middle school. Now, most of you might be aware that drama is a very physical subject, but it also has a very strong knowledge aspect to it. And in the curriculum, we are going to explore different aspects of drama, such as acting, movement, voice modulation, speech, creative writing, and design. The academic year is roughly divided into three units. The first unit will be focused on a specific element of theatre, such as costume design, or set design, or light design. And we are going to explore the element by using it in a piece of theatre. It will be completely student-driven. The second unit will be focused on a full-fledged production, which is basically creating a play on stage. The third unit, it will be focused on understanding a specific form of theater or a tradition of theater and understand the cultural aspects related to it. For example, Yakshagana from Karnataka, or Japanese puppet theater, or Commedia dell'arte from Italy. We will try to explore one such form and see what are the cultural influences that help giving this form a shape. Hence, in drama, we learn about the form itself, its elements such as acting, movement, speech, voice, and stage design, costume design, light and sound design, and also how different cultures have their unique form of theater. And all this with the fun and thrill of doing lots of drama. Thank you.
Hello everyone, hope you are doing good. So my name is Sangeet Rao. I teach music for middle school, and this video is all about not just what is the difference between PYP and middle school. In PYP, you have learned so far not just general music like basic music theory, singing techniques, those things. But whereas in middle school, we are going to learn in depth. So for example, not just you have an option to select your instruments. You have different instruments. For example, I can say, so you can learn piano, guitar, keyboard. And for each instrument, we have no separate curriculum for everything. So and each curriculum, like, you know, just we have books for, you know, for especially for piano, John Thompson music book, and for guitar, Alfred music thing. And for every instruments, right, there are not just basic, not just, and worldwide famous, not just music books are available here. So you can learn things in in-depth way, and hope to see you all in this one middle school section.
Greeting Candorians, this is the HOD of the PE and Sports Department. I'd like to welcome you to the next level of your development as a student athlete. We are ecstatic and proud to have you in this next level. The coaching staff and the entire facility has been developed for you to enhance your skills and potential. We look forward to facilitating you in the sports and in PE. We would like to let you know that there would be a ratio of at least 70% practical and 30% theory. The same sports are offered as we did last year. We expect a great amount of discipline, commitment, and dedication from your part. The department is here to facilitate you in whatever aspect of sport you may require. We are very proud that you have completed the previous year academically and online, and we are looking forward to facilitating you once again.
Hi, I'm Meghna, and I'm the visual arts teacher for middle school. In the upcoming year, the students will be introduced to art history, which I believe is vital to learn drawing and painting. Art history includes different art movements starting from the 1300s till the present. Now, art movements means artists forming different groups with a common goal or philosophy and painting in a similar style. Every class will start with a history session, which will be followed by a practical session based on what they learned previously. There are a lot of styles in art, and the students will be taught the styles basic in theory and in practical. They will be taught how to draw and paint in different styles until they have learned or realized their own style or what their inclination is. And then once that is done, we can learn on enhancing that. We will also be doing something called mixed media, the translation of which is mixed materials, which means that our art will not just be limited to paper and painting and 2D, but they are going to go beyond 2D, trying to collect materials from around them, trying to use scrap materials into their painting and go beyond 2D and create something more contemporary. They say that every art piece tells a story, and this is what I will be teaching them. I will be teaching them something called narrative, teaching them how to narrate a feeling or an event or a story in the form of art. So this is the curriculum in brief for the upcoming year. Thank you.